came and knelt down to me with your body gifts. Because they told Herod that the king, there's been a king that was born. They tried to kill me. Herod killed babies under 3 years old, trying to kill the baby Jesus. But then they took him to Egypt for protection. And he grew up. And then their mom, his mom and dad, Joseph and Mary, saw him not in the family. He was missing. And where did they find him? They found him in the temple. And he was doing, he said, "Mom, don't you know I'm very faithful? Mom, don't you know I had to be by my father's business?" And for 33 and a half years, he was on this earth. He was rejected by men. They wanted to throw him off of a mountain because he claimed to be the great I Am. He claimed to be the Son of God. But when he got on that cross, he said, "It is finished. It is finished." And he came, and he went back up to the glory. He went back up and to save us. And you know, the Bible says that the angels rejoice over one lost sinner that comes to God. And we are to rejoice when that young lady right here that came to God today. Because that's what Jesus came for. That's what he came for. And I thank God that he gave me another chance. I thank God that he saw fit not to let me die in my sins. But he gave me another chance. He's given us so much chances because of his love. Because of his love.
They often go see relatives. They also go to parties, friends' houses, and church services. This Christmas, I want to encourage you to go to Bethlehem. That's what a group of lowly shepherds did on the very first Christmas. After the angels announced Jesus' birth, these shepherds said, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." That's coming from Luke 2:15. Now it's our turn to go to Bethlehem and see with fresh eyes the one who miraculously came. From heaven to earth to save us from our sins. As the scriptures foretold, "Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given." Isaiah 9:6. Jesus is God become man. He was given to us. Let us open our hearts to adore and admire him. Miraculous birth. When we take a closer look at the miraculous birth of Jesus, we notice some important spiritual truths. First, we notice his miraculous conception. Amen. God went to him. The Holy Spirit. It was a thing unheard of before and unparalleled since that a virgin should conceive and bear a son. Our Savior, although truly man, was also fully God. Amen. That's awesome. The Son of God became a man to enable man to enable. I didn't know what enable means. Some of us sometimes we disabled. We was disabled in the world, but Jesus came to enable us. Enable men to become sons of God and daughters of God. Let us thank God for this undeserved, this earthly appearance. His mother was described simply as a virgin, not a princess, a queen, or an empress of a large estate. Yes, the child within her womb was from the Spirit of God, but her status and position was humble and lowly. Mary and Joseph were not rich. Thus, Jesus ended up being born in a manger, a filling proof for animals, a feeding proof for animals, hardly a describable setting. Nevertheless, God humbles the proud.
Yeah. Amen. the ninth verse, after the manner therefore pray ye. This is the Lord saying, after the manner pray ye. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Come on.
Let's say that again.
Yes.
But deliver us.
Everybody has a purpose that is different. But the thing is one body. Whether I'm my own hand,
Because the giving comes from the heart. The giving comes from knowing that no matter what we do, God has the best gift that anybody can receive. And that's the gift of the Holy Ghost, that's the gift of love, and that's the gift of patience, understanding, because I'm pretty sure sometimes we neglect him too. Because that's why he has to chastise us. And sometimes he has to knock us down. But yes, I thank God for being here today. I thank God for strength, for patience, for understanding. And I thank God for love. And I thank God for just knowing that no matter what we go through, no matter who we might feel that is against us, it's all going to come around to the gift of it, because it's strength. It's where we have to know that we bow down to him. We rise up to him. Because without any of that, we won't be able to do any of it, because he's the one that breathes life into us. So we thank God this day, this year, for breathing life into his people and to giving us the understanding that it's not just about gifts, it's about his love, his birth, his death, his resurrection. And I thank y'all, and I
But that's not how the story is. 3 days
Amen.
Later, he rose again. That's love. That's love. There is no greater love. There is no greater love. There is no greater love. No greater love. Amen.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. We got to know what the word is saying. Amen. Right here, we're going to call the usher.
Yes, it is.
I thank you, hallelujah. I thank you for saving me one day. I've been saving you, hallelujah. Filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. your tongue.
Hallelujah, glory to God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. And my first scripture, I got three of them. One of them is Titus 3, 1 through 2. The next one's going to be James 3, 5, and 6. And the next one's going to be Proverbs 18, 21. Okay. Turn to Titus 3, 1 and 2. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm on the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, he's so worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. And I pray to him. Hallelujah. Everybody stand up on their feet. Read Titus 3, 1, 2, 2. 1 and 2. Okay, it says, 1 says, 3, 1 says, put them in mind to be subject to principalities, and power to obey.
Thank you, Lord.
To be ready to every good work. Mm. 2 said to speak evil of no man, to be no battler, that all right, good problems, but gentlemen showing all meekness
yes,
to all.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
you, Jesus.
Okay. And I begin to look up the definition of gentleman. It said with a mind, mild, kind, temperament of life. And then it said again, back
three.
It said a citizen officer charged with the administration of the law. And then I looked up malice. The intention, a desire to do evil. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I'm going to go back and read you reading from me. One more time. Titus 3, 1 through 2.
Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers, to obey magistrates, to be ready to every good work, to speak evil of no man, to be no brawler, but gentle, showing all meekness unto all men.
Lord, we pray for right now. Hallelujah is speak for himself. Then James 3, 5, and 6. No matter what you're going through, If you get your heart right, and I heard Mother say this, Mother stuff, she said, just look at everybody like this, Jesus. Sometimes it's hard to do that, because when you see the thing, you say, well, I know Jesus wouldn't be there for that right there. No, or not. But I tell you, I pray for that. And it works for me. You know, I don't know about, but that's just some things I'm putting out. When I say stuff, I just be trying to help.
Amen. Come on.
I remember I had told, I knew this again, but I got to say this for you. I said, one thing about tithe, if you don't include it in your money, if you get $200 and you get $180, you ain't got to worry about that money because you can't get nothing done with it. So, if you saying $180 instead of $200, then you don't need how that in no way. So it began to be easy for me to pay tithe. Not saying I did it like that all the time, because I don't feel down right up in here. But I'm saying one thing about God, he'll bring stuff back to your memory to get you better on track.
Come on.
And I remember Sister Bridget, she was talking about it. And I liked the way she did it because she said she was explaining it to me, and that really helped me too. And I got back on track when she said it. So a lot of times that we can say to each other that we can be happy with each other. So getting back to that tone. I was the type, I could say talk without three words without cussing. And I thank God because see, I'm delivered now.
Amen.
I've been standing up here how long? That was a cuss word came out of my mouth. All
right.
So I thank God. When y'all should be praying so much, I go back to my mind. I think about where he had brought me.
Come on, that's good.
And I'm not ashamed of anything that I've been through, hallelujah. Because anybody I can help on this boat trying to make it to Jesus, help like me, I don't mind, hallelujah. Some people understand. They say, I put my business out there. I ain't got no business, hallelujah. Because he told me, hallelujah, death might work in me, that life might work in them.
Come on.
And I don't want to see somebody, hallelujah, God working in them. I don't want to see, because I know some of the things I've been through, hallelujah. And I tell you, hallelujah, I really be wanna by marriage. Because I've been through some stuff. And I'm gonna be talking about that one day too. When I was married, hallelujah. Think that you know it's a married people in here, hallelujah. They can look at but that, wait a minute, is that right now? Because I remember having a sister one day. And I said, you got a minute to say this about me. Hallelujah. I'm just talking, just talking, just tell her what he was saying. You know, that girl started crying. I said, well, what's wrong with you? It wasn't bad as I thought it was, not that I listened to you. My husband ain't do nothing wrong with me like I thought. So I'm saying, I'm glad that I was open to say that to her. Because it helped her. Knowing that my husband said something, maybe what should have been what you said to her. So anyway, that's what I'm about, y'all. I totally give them a lot of them because I try to live a true life.
Amen.
And I, by doing that right there, I try to stick with the truth. I try it sometimes because I know I'm not perfect. I know I do some stuff. But the thing about it is, I want to help somebody.
Amen.
I want to help anyway, and I want souls to go on to the kingdom.
Amen.
So when I stand up here and I'm talking about me, I'm trying to help whoever out there. Because believe it or not, it'd be somebody out there 9 times out of 10. Because God just don't have you say stuff that you can say. There's a reason. So, get back to James 3:5-6.
All right.
Okay. Then it says, it can tear down and it can build up.
Mm.
It's a small member of the body, but it can carry a lot of power.
Wow.
And I thank God, well, you know, the word gets your prayer for it, and that's what God has written on.
Yes, yes.
Because I want to know what the seven women said and how to say it. And the same token, we need to help somebody.
by the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall be the fruit thereof.
You know, God has really been dealing with me for saying about you can speak death to a situation, but you can speak like this. And I remember I was talking to somebody, and they said, they girl gonna mess around and she's gonna be afraid. I said, no. You know what I maybe started doing? I pray. For these things I see and I just know it's gonna happen. I feel like on me it's gonna happen. To them, I learned life and death is in the power of the tongue. So,
yes, it is.
When I see a situation, I say, I pray that she don't be afraid. You know, I start praying, I pray again, because you can see all the everything that's going on, I'm lining up, and you know what I'm doing, I'm thinking. That's what you think. But it ain't about what you think or what you feel like they had to you. It's that you should be there to say, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Now I see she doing this. I see this right here going on, though. But I tell you right now, I'm going to pray, hallelujah, for a change, hallelujah. And that's even with stuff that we see with each other that's going on. We see a lot of stuff that's going on. You know, I like, you know, y'all was stupid every time I said something about mother, but she had done a very good impact on me years ago when she would say stuff. And I can't help but to say her name. And she'll say, well, don't judge nobody because you got something going on in your tongue. I'm not doing that, but it's something going on with you. So if all of us get together, we start praying about what's going on in the situation, we'll get some good results then. Because, I'm going to tell y'all, trying to get away from it, and I think I just about away from it. I don't see nothing but what's in Queen. If I look at myself and see what's wrong with me, I ain't got time to see what's going on.
Come on, Prophet.
In the church, something going on. The best thing for me to do is to pray. And I tell you, hallelujah, I've been doing it, y'all.
Amen.
And I tell you, it's been making a difference in me, hallelujah.
Amen.
It's been helping me, hallelujah. Because you see her back there, that's my sister. We don't ever say nothing about nobody. We don't ever say nothing about herself, her truth that she chose to tell you. Amen. But other than that, anything going on or anything, that's what she do. She don't say nothing about that. She prayed when she see the situation. And that's what I let God away from.
All right.
Coming back that way again.
All right.
Because one thing about it, Lord have mercy. Sister Queen doing this right here. You know, Sister Queen. Now, look, let's get together. Let's pray for Sister Queen.
Amen.
Because one thing about it, she's in the church. She's trying to do it at the hospital.
Come on now.
So she could still be out there doing this and that.
Yeah.
But that's a step, hallelujah.
Yes,
that she made her mind, hallelujah, to get in the church house instead of the club house, hallelujah.
Right.
And I appreciate God, hallelujah.
Yes.
I thank God, hallelujah. Oh, I glorify, hallelujah. Yes, I was a backbiter, hallelujah.
Amen.
But I tell you, can't be a backbiter, hallelujah. And God performed in your life like you.
Come on now,
hallelujah.
come on.
But anyway, I'm going to pray for the
And she was talking to me, and she said, that's between me and you, man. Just sitting up talking. I said, babe, I don't do that. I said, when I see stuff, I pray about it before you realize it. I don't talk about it. I said, I pray for it. So then she started crying. She said, I'm so glad you told me. She said, so you ain't never got to worry about me talking to mom, you about to go back. She said, because it ain't right to do that. It ain't right to talk about people, especially the one that in Christ in the house of God.
Come on.
So I'll put myself out there so nobody will think I'm terrible.
Come on.
Had to be delivered. And it feel good. That I can walk in here and I can hug everybody for real now.
Thank you, Jesus.
My smile is for real. Because anything I want to say, I'll say, I'm going to say it to you. You never got to worry about something going on. I'm going to come to you and I'm going to say it like I did in your book. And if in some kind of way you get to me and you say, well, Sister Queen, I don't like the way you say it today. But Sister Queen, could you say it a little bit? Because you ain't going to have to worry about if I like you or not. Because I ain't gonna have no reason not to like you, because I'm gonna told you, we're gonna be talk about everything that's going on. Because okay? Y'all don't realize this walk with God. Thank you, Jesus. I just don't want to go on there that he said, turn away from me, you work in there. I never knew. I don't wanna say I sung in your name. I prophesied in your name.
Wow.
I preached in your name.
Come on now.
But hallelujah, hallelujah. I get to my Jesus, hallelujah. And he tells me, hallelujah. Turn away from me. You reckon that I never knew you, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But I want to say, well done.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You want to look at my children. You got to say, hallelujah. And I appreciate God to say, hallelujah. And if God, hallelujah. That I can help, hallelujah.
Saying so much of it.
It's good when you can see yourself. Amen. And to see where you need to come up, where the error that you have made. That's it, right? That's just about seeing yourself. Amen. Once we when we see ourselves, we get in the mirror and we don't see nobody else. All
right.
In the mirror. We don't see nobody else but yourself. You dress in the mirror. When I'm dressing in the mirror, brush my hair, whatever I'm going in the mirror, ain't nobody else in the mirror. Nobody else in the mirror. God showed me in the mirror. He don't bring nobody else in the mirror with him. He shows me in the mirror. So I thank God today. Amen. I serve. Thank God for the word. Thank God. Amen. God bless. Amen. We got one more Sunday. I thank you for the year. Amen. This is the fifth Sunday.